What's up, guys? Wiz the Wiz here. Today we're going to be starting a new series. The game we're going to be playing is Fallout 3. Now, Fallout 3 has always been a favorite of mine. I've played it many times. It's just such a great game, you know? We're going to start from the beginning, and I'm going to do a playthrough of the main quest. Maybe do more if you guys want to, like the side quests. Just because this is a pretty big game, and I want to keep the series manageable, I'm just going to stick to the main quest. Again, unless you guys want me to do the other things. In which case, I will. So let's go ahead and just start from the beginning. And now I'm going to pop out for a second, because I want you guys to actually get part of the, just get the essence of the game, you know? Alright, I'll see you in a sec.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be complete. I don't set the world on
war. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Hmm.
That's a baby!
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl?
I am definitely a boy.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
Son, we are going to name you T. Widge. That's right, I'm T. Widge.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Okay. I'm just gonna zoom through this just a little bit. Oh, hell no, no. This really isn't crucial to the story, so... I don't know. Yeah, I'm just gonna run through this real quick. Let's go to hair. Why not? Hair color. I am a ginger. It's like, I don't know, my hair is more auburn than ginger. I don't know. Maybe I'm just, I don't know. Whatever. Whatever color it is, it's reddish. That works for me. Yeah, I'm gonna call that good.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compression.
Yep.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay. That's my mom!
We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations and there will be
look straight into the light now.
James and his chili chatter.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
All right.
This place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to daddy.
All right.
You can make it.
So much action. Oh yeah, baby
there
walking.
There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal.
Sure, Pops, I got it. Dad's gone! Tear up the place! Ah, whatever. Close enough. I'm gonna take all my toys out. There you go. Oh, you don't want to I want the truck. Can I do anything with that? No, I forgot. Oh, yep. Whoa, I'm a talker. God, I love this game so much. It feels good to be playing it again. I haven't played it in so long. It's been like, well, I don't know, it's only been a couple years, but whatever, that's a long time for me. This is a small ass room. Oh man, if only I was taller, I could reach the lock. Was I supposed to do that this whole time?
Baby.
Okay. So I know agility, you want to put that up in the beginning of the game, honestly. Because it sucks to do it later. The rest of the stuff, you know, depending on who you're playing as, I know that I like to wear, so there's power armor in this game, and when your agility is up, you can move faster in the power armor because it takes away some of that, and it's just, it could be a little annoying for some people, but, so I put it up in the beginning, I don't remember what all these do. I know that luck helps you out. Yeah, sure, why not strength? God, get. Where to go?
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amata wants to play.
Yep, playtime.
Baby.
These experiments
don't
be
a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Hey!
He was growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother.
Young man.
Okay, just interrupt him.
I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it.
Sweet.
You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party.
I don't like that laugh, but...
You're only 10 once, so
screw it. I got... Hell, this is pretty much an iPod or iTouch. Screw it, it's my smartphone. There we go. Alright, let's mingle.
We really surprised. Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
a date with Christine Kendall.
Ha, I knew I surprised you.
I don't know.
Who's your favorite barbarian?
That's I don't right, wanna, Grognak. Usually issue I don't play the 14, bad guy in these games.
And with no missing pages. I found this in a box.
Now, if you guys want me to play the bad guy, I will.
Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody.
Well, oh, crap.
I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Oh, man.
Sweet.
And you got a pit boy. I wish I was 10.
We look the hold on. We're like the same age. Yourself?
Happy Whatever. Birthday.
You'll be there soon.
Hey, happy birthday, nosebleed.
This is a dick.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am.
Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone.
Sweet.
It's time to cut the cake.
Andy, wait.
Oh, this...
Enjoy yourself.
Sweet party hat.
Oh, no.
Allow me to wish you a happy
Swag.
Birthday.
Swag.
I would offer you a piece of cake,
but you fucked it up.
Daddy, I told you not to act all of...
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that
This kid's a little shit. Oh. That's so messed up. You do look hungry. What, your mom drank up all the ration coupons again? it's not funny. It's not funny. It's funny. That's harsh. I'm just gonna say this.
Oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
Official, you're gonna be smoking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nonsense. People always
You ain't got burners?
Speeches.
Butch, Besides, what do you think you're doing?
Yours,
Leave him alone.
A reminder that life is not all fun and games.
You all right, son? I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me? Why, that little? I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
You got it.
This is supposed to be a party, you know? Fun? You should try it sometime, Daddy. You might like it.
We're not.
Yeah, you need it.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk.
I know, right?
Come on, don't ask me that. You know he would if I asked, but where would that leave me? It's bad enough being the overseer's daughter. If everyone knew I ran to Daddy every time I had a problem, nobody would ever talk to me again.
True.
We'll think of some way to get Butch back, I promise. But I'm not getting my father involved.
Got Remember, one? I'm keeping my
Happy
eye
birthday.
On you.
Super cool, right?
All right, then.
Jeez, Wally,
we surprised
the head of the gang.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
You are
I'm
me.
Sure of it.
No way.
Man,
never suspected it.
Little assholes down here.
Go on and enjoy yourself.
Hey, you
talk to this dude.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Can't beat that.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
How's it going, pal?
Thanks for coming, Stan.
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again?
I like how the officer stopped what was going on. My dad was, like, right there. Or the dad.
I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
I know you were busy with the water purifier. Everything's fine, I hope.
Who?
Oh, sure, talk to worry about. Happy birthday, Sonny.
Okay.
Are you having a nice time?
How are you enjoying the party, okay. Mrs. Palmer?
You guys are dumb.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you. For some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Somebody's gotta have a better idea than those.
All right, then.
Oh,
really?
I got it.
They're
man, this is a great one.
You did
the grease
such a splendid
what
job.
Do you guys think?
Joan.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
Being a prick?
What, are you
okay.
two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft.
Thanks. I'll send them right down.
Yeah, Paul.
I'm
why don't you introduce
here.
Us to your new...
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
All right.
We're best friends.
Keep in touch with the young people, you
what
know,
do you mean,
Dork
Face here?
Plus, well,
happy birthday,
like
Dork
parties.
Face.
Oh, it's this way.
Sure thing, Officer Gomez.
Happy birthday.
Well, it's been nice.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it.
That's nice.
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Chatting with you.
Enjoying.
Gray walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation, little hands groping in subterranean uncertainty. Mommy, Daddy, am I dead? Nay, nay, reborn into purifying fluorescence. A face emerges, strong and male. Father to me, father to all. Overseeing our lives, our internet... Oh my god, can I not read? Harshness of discipline, harshness of love, obedience, my savior. Larva to pupa, pupa to worker, buzz, buzz. One with the steel honeycomb, 10 lies within the 101. Significant at last. Till gray seeps from walls, to hair, to soul, then eternal slumber, the sweet sleep of incineration. Well then!
Thanks again for coming!
That's a little dark! He's 10, he probably can't understand it anyway.
Thank you for coming, Miss Beatrice.
Hey, Paul,
I hope you're having a nice time.
Reactor!
What are you doing down here, young man?
I'm not a kid. I'm 10.
You sure
I'm
are.
All grown up.
Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Sweet.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Jack the spring out of the switchblade.
We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Where did I get that? Eh, I'm not gonna question it. Hell yeah, I got a baseball cap. I'm a badass.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help.
Happy birthday, buddy. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Sweet.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB
gun? Oh, hell yeah.
Just aim.
Oh, shit. Okay, maybe not. Pa! I will use VATS. Vault Tech Assisted Targeting System. Yeah, I think that's what it stands for. Anyway. Pa! Sweet.
Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile.
We look so close.
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is your problem anyway? So, I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? Like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a GOAT to take. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the GOAT. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test, GOAT. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
Hmm. Alright, I'm gonna...
Take care, son.
I'm gonna move on. Just because I kind of want to get out of the vault this episode.
Good morning.
I don't know if it's... I don't think it's gonna happen, though.
Tunnel snakes?
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God,
he's a creep.
Why don't you just leave me alone?
Let's go
what
into the storeroom.
What are you gonna do, Amata? Go
I'll
run
show
and
you
tell your daddy
time.
On us?
Stay away from me.
Yeah? What do you want? None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes.
I kind of want to fight him. I'm going to fight him.
And who are you? Keep talking like that, boy, and we'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix.
Did you know, due to the threats of radiation and mutant domination, the United States will not be habitable again for at least 3 centuries?
You've got to be kidding me. Come on, Tunnel Snakes. This twerp needs another
Hey, lesson. I said one-on-one. Oh, shit. All right.
Stop it. Leave him alone.
Tough guy, huh?
Give him another... Hit him again.
Please, stop fighting.
Come on, Tunnel Snakes. Okay. You win. We'll leave the little girl alone. You're not worth our time anyway. Come on, Tunnel Snakes. We're out of here.
Whatever you say. I just whooped your ass.
Tunnel Snakes,
hey,
Susie, what's new?
Fine. Let's go.
Oh, thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father is the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Not much.
All right.
Our heater's on the fritz again.
Let me know if there are any changes.
You're kidding me. Didn't you just get new parts for it last week?
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. Listen, I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher.
Mm-hmm.
So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come out, and I'll take care of it for you.
Hey.
Well, all right. Here, take a look.
Bang, bang. Okay. No. I'm gonna do science. Everything else. Oh, crap! Okay, I remember what skill I forgot to do. Intelligence. That's what you need, because then you get more... okay. You get more, skills that you can level up each time you get to a new level. Okay. There are skill points to spend. Alright. I'm gonna have to fix that, but, alright, let's call that done. Whoa, okay, so it looks like we've been recording for a while. I'm gonna end this episode here. Don't worry, I'll be right back. I'm gonna record the second episode right after this, because I have enough time today. But until then, I'll see you in the next episode. Leave a like if you enjoyed and help support this series. Alright, I'll see you later, guys.
Yes, I'm talking.